In this video, we're going to talk about the number zero. We need to talk about what happens when zero is included in a division problem, and specifically what happens if it is the dividend or the divisor. That's a lot of vocabulary, but what we need to figure out is if it's in the numerator of a fraction or the denominator of a fraction, what happens? Remember, fractions are just like divisions, where the denominator tells you how many groups you're putting the numerator into. So when dividing by zero, it helps to remember the grouping rule of division. Six divided by three implies how many groups of three I have. Another way you could write 6 divided by 3 is 6 over 3. So, if we're looking at how many groups of 3 I have, I can break this into a group of 3 here and a group of 3 here. So, I have 2 groups of 3. 0 divided by 4 implies how many groups of 4 I have. So if I have 0 and I divide it by 4, I'm still only going to have 0 groups. There's nothing in here. So 0 divided by 4 equals 0. And up here, we talked about 2. All right, so let's move on to the next one. This is the tricky one. This is the one everyone gets stuck on. If I have 6 and I divide it by 0, this implies how many groups of 0 I have. And 0 is not helpful, because if I'm trying to divide by 0, I can't group this in a logical way. And so what we say is any number, we're using 6 right now, divided by 0 is undefined. And in your homework, you will need to be able to identify if it's in the numerator. You get 0 when you divide by any number, but if it's in the denominator, it's undefined. Let's take a look at these examples. Remember, if we have a number first and then a division sign and the second number is 0, we would rewrite that as 20 divided by 0, and we say this is undefined. However, in example 2, we can rewrite this as 0 because the 0 is in the numerator. And we're done.